Hi Aries, welcome to my channel. So we are doing your reading for August 2020. All right, so let's see what does this month, that is August, is bringing for you. All right, so as you all know, this is a general reading. It might or might not resonate with all of you. And for those who are new to my channel, a warm welcome to you all. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification icon as well, so that you will be able to get updated about my latest videos. All right, so while I was pre-shuffling, Aries, what I got was the first card was Queen of Cups. A fire sign behaving like a water sign, very emotional. You are feeling very emotional, but you are silent, I'm seeing, because you also had Temperance with Ten of Cups. You know, you are emotional. You want to start a family, or there is someone because of whom you are feeling emotional. I was seeing that, but you know what your heart wants, but it's more of a thing that what should I do? Because there were some confusion as well with the Seven of Cups and Two of Wands also came up. So you are confused to take an action, because you want, see, money is something which you actually want right now, but somewhere, you know, somewhere inside your heart, you still think about someone. There is someone in your heart, but you are not able to express the feelings. That is why Queen of Cups was there. You are emotional, you are feeling like you love someone, you like someone, but you are not able to express those feelings. All right, so let's see what does the card say now. This was a message from my pre-shuffle. Let's see, what do we have other than that? Let's see. So I'll be looking at your past energies, future, present and future energies. All right, so there was something, you know, Queen of Pentacles also was there in your pre-shuffles. Okay, a lot of major arcanas over here. Four major. All right. And the Lovers. All right. So see, I told you, you are in love, but you are not able to express your feelings. You are not able to tell the other person that I like you, I love you. It's all inside your heart, I'm seeing. All right, so your past energies are Page of Pentacles, Knight of Cups, and Queen of Pentacles. There was a beginning of this new love or something like that, because I'm seeing Page of Pentacles with, you know, all the three cards from the suits. Page of Pentacles, the Knight of Cups, and Queen of Pentacles. So this was really slow. It was not done, you know, it was not so... you were not feeling so rushy over here, because I'm seeing the Pentacles and Cups over here. So these energies are not very much harsh, and you never rushed in this communication or this relationship in whichever you were. And you always thought that, let's take it slow, I just want to, you know, understand this person. You wanted to just know this person, you know. It was an energy like where when you take time in knowing someone and you just develop feelings. There were some talks, obviously, with the Knight of Cups. This is the Playboy card of the deck. It was like, okay, let's take it slow. Let's talk and take it slow. Yeah. So in your present energies, I'm seeing the Wheel of Fortune, the Magician, and Eight of Cups. So time has changed, but there is something, you know, the Magician and Eight of Cups, they are not giving me good vibes over here. I don't know whether it's you or the other person, but with the Magician and Eight of Cups, somebody took a step over here and somebody left someone. See, Magician knows that I have to do this. Magician knew it, and Magician took the step. You might be the Magician over here, or might be the other person, but somebody left someone over here, and it was going good. it was going good, but all of a sudden something happened, and you know, the wheel just turned, and we will clarify the wheel of fortune though. All right, so in your future energies, the cards are the High Priestess, King of Swords, and the Empress. I'm seeing you are going in a direction where you know your feelings. I'm seeing over here, you know your feelings. The High Priestess and the Empress is telling me that, you know, if I like someone, it's fine then. You know, sometimes you just don't take an action over here. With the King of Swords, I'm not seeing that you are taking an action towards this relationship, but more you are taking an action for yourself. You are becoming practical. You know, you are becoming that person where you are mature enough to know what to do. You are not a child anymore who will just go towards this person and beg for him or her. You are more into a growing period, I'm seeing over here, in your future energies. And you will be really practical that if this person is meant to be with me, he or she will come back, or the universe will make, you know, the fate. You are all dependent on the fate, because with the Wheel of Fortune over here, it's luck card basically. So you have actually just, you left it on the God or on fate. You are no more doing anything in regards with the relationship, but you are doing your self growth. All right, so let's see what the cards have. Let's clarify the Lovers in the overall energy. Lovers, please. Okay. Six of Pentacles. What else do we have? And Knight of Swords. You are feeling over here that with the Six of Pentacles and Knight of Swords, I'm getting an energy, I'm getting a feeling where you are just, you know, you are more in that zone where you're ready to move on. You have given enough. You are thinking that it's enough now, I have given enough. Now, let's just, you know, maintain a balance over here. You are more in that balance mode where you just want to be someone who is more into himself or herself. You know, with the Empress in your future energy as well. So you have done. You are done. Basically, you gave the love from your side. Everything was actually, it was a mutual connection. I'm seeing over here with the Six of Pentacles. It was not only you who were giving, it was from both the sides, because that is why the past energies are really good. Page of Pentacles, Knight of Cups, and Queen of Pentacles. You know, it actually grew with time. First, it was Page, then it was Knight of Cups. So, Page, Knight, Queen, and King. It was meant to be, but something happened and you just walked away. You both were, you know, separated. It was growing, this relationship I'm seeing over here. You started knowing each other, then it came as Knight of Cups, so a romantic connection started building up, which actually was going into something more mature. You know, with the Queen of Pentacles, it's a kind of a maturity zone. Let's see, what is this Page of Pentacles? What else do we have? Okay. So many cards. So I got the Devil over here. What else do we have other than Devil? And King of Rods. Alright. So this is you. I really feel that this thing was something, you know, you were very much, I'm not feeling a bad energy with the Devil over here. It's more like you were so passionate about this person, about this communication, that you went on. You were just going with the flow. With the Devil and King of Rods, it gave you a lot of, you know, happiness, a lot of it might be some kind of attraction as well, but obviously, you know, first time when we see someone, when you start talking to someone, it's more of an attraction. You don't know that person, but the good point is you started knowing this person, and that grew up, and it just went on smoothly. Let's see, what is this Knight of Cups in your past energies? Okay, Ten of Wands we have over here. What else? And the Moon. All right, some kind of a secret. Moon talks about secrets. This is Pisces and Cancer energy. Might be, you might know these secrets. I'm feeling over here that you knew everything. That is why there was some kind of, you know, you liked the relationship. This bonding was really good. But there were some things which you cannot hide. You knew these things, but you couldn't hide these things. And that is actually, that was a pressure on your head. You were thinking about these things and you couldn't share with anyone. And that is why, you know, it just, the pressure just came upon you and it started to build and, you know, more and more and more. So that actually reached a level. All right. So let's see, what is this Queen of Pentacles in your past energies? We have the Chariot. What else do we have? Queen of Pentacles. Queen of Pentacles. Clarified by Queen of Pentacles with the Chariot. Alright, so put it like this. Alright, so see, Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles, and Chariot. This was a really mature relationship, Aries. This was something, you know, it was a stable relationship. Where you are ready to move on. I think both of you were ready to, you both were on the same page. Yes, I would say that. Because see, both of you looking at each other and both have same energies towards each other. And you actually wanted to grow with this person. You wanted to move on. But there were some things which you cannot hide sometimes. That is why I think this secret, this something, you know, it was not meant to be, you know, just to keep a secret. I'll clarify this Moon card once again. Let's see, what does this Moon has? You had so much of, all right, some kind of information. The Page of Swords. It's looking like some kind of information you got to know. Some new information, something new you, might be somebody told you online stuff. There was something related. But I think you, yeah, this might be for some people you already knew it and that actually became a burden, or for someone, some people you actually got to know something new about this person, and that is why, you know, you were on the same page, but still sometimes you cannot keep some things, you cannot just digest some things. That is why I'm seeing that you are taking a step in at present of moving on. Let's see, what is this Wheel of Fortune in your present energies? Wheel of Fortune in the present energies. What is this Wheel of Fortune, please? Okay, Eight of Cups again. Yeah, moving on. This is what I'm getting. You're just leaving this place with the Queen of Swords. All right, so I got it. So whatever this information was, whether it was something or whether it was nothing, whatever this thing was, it actually broke you as well as the other person. You know, over here also, the 2 8 of Cups over here, I'm seeing that both of you moved on. And there was some kind of an, not argument, but some kind of an, you know, that feeling where the, I'm seeing that this is, this might not be you or might be you as well, but I'm seeing that with the wheel of fortune, everything just took a U-turn. You know, everything was going on smooth. I'm seeing that in your past energies, everything was fine. So much of passion, so much of enthusiasm, stability, maturity in your relationship. Everything was fine. But some kind of a trigger might be, this might be some other person as well. With this Page of Swords is not looking to me really good. You know, this might be some other person who came in between you both, and they just told you something about them, or there's something. So I really feel there's something fishy over here. So that is why some kind of a cold talk, I would say, that, you know, a cold talk might not be just in front of each other. That person might have said you something, or you might have said something to that other person, and you just parted ways. You both parted your ways. You never talked. I'm seeing you're not talking anymore with this person. Let's see the Magician over here. What is this Magician in your present energies? Nine of Wands. You're not talking. You might even have blocked this person, or that person might have blocked you as well. There are no talkings over here. But I'm seeing that with the Magician, I'm seeing that it's you who actually, you know, not talking to this person anymore. But love is there still. Love is there. Those feelings can never go away when you start feeling about, because your pre-shuffle cards were also saying this. Queen of Cups was the first card for you, Aries, and you, yes, justice. So yes, you took a decision, or might be you are taking a decision at present. Something is happening and you are more into a zone where it's better to move on. No talking over here. Nothing is going on, basically. You are just moving this, you are moving this way, and the other person is moving this way, and you are not even seeing each other. You don't know what is happening. You might have talked once, but that was all. Nobody justified anything, I'm seeing over here. You know, you might have heard their part of the story, or they might have heard your part of the story, but it was not a both way communication. I'm seeing over here, it was more like only one way communication. One person said something and that's it. All right, so let's see what is the High Priestess in your future energies. The Emperor. What else do we have other than Emperor over here? The Fool. Alright, and King of Swords. So the Emperor and the Fool, these both are your energies over here. I feel that you are taking a step in future, but it's more regarding just new journey for yourself. I'm not seeing that you are taking a step in regards with this communication or this relationship. You are just moving on, because King of Swords came twice over here in your future energies as well. And I'm seeing that the communication or whatever you both felt, that was really mature. Whatever you felt, if you both felt that, you know, you are meant to be together, it was actually, you know, you were actually meant to be together. But might be both of your egos or self-respect, they have come so much so high that you both have parted the ways, and you both are determined over here. With the King of Swords and Emperor, you both are still in the same page. You know, when you were Queen of Pentacles, when you were together in the relationship, you were in the same page, and now again you are in the same page, because you both left together. You both are determined not to talk with this person. You both are like this, no, we will not talk. Both of your energies are telling me this. You're not going to take any step. Let's see what is this Empress telling us in the future energies. Two of Wands over here. Okay. What is this Two of Wands telling us? What is this Two of Wands telling us over here? clarify, please. Two of Wands and Empress. We have a card. All right. So we have Nine of Pentacles. These energies are both of your energy, you and your partner's energy. Let's clarify once again. One more card, please. Wheel of Fortune again. Wheel of Fortune coming again is something, you know, you have, I know that you left to you have left everything towards the God. Basically, you are just telling yourself, you are just telling yourself that okay, I'm done, I don't know, whatever, if we are meant to be together, we will be together. That is something which your energies are, because with the Wheel of Fortune coming again, it's like, again, it's U-turn, it's coming again. But both of you are in that zone, you both are in different paths, you know. Basically, you both are in same paths, but you're not together. All right, see, with the Empress and Queen and Nine of Pentacles, this is looking to me like, you know, you both are, you are this, or this is you, or this is them, or this is you, something like that. And you are into your work, they are into their work. You both are growing within yourself. There is some kind of a growth within yourself which is going. But the Wheel of Fortune is telling me something else. Okay, so might be there is a turn, you know, wheel is turning, because this is Jupiter. And yeah, so Capricorn is in Jupiter is in Capricorn, and there's something which is going on within these 6 months, no, August, September, yeah, within December 2020, things might change. All right, so let's see what does the universe has. Let's see any more clarification cards or advice from the universe. Let's see for my Aries, please. We have three cards over here. Four cards, all right. Judgment, Ace of Pentacles, Queen of Rods, and Eight of Pentacles. The universe is telling you that, you know, just enjoy. You know, just if you are busy in your work, just go and be busy. Be busy, do some work, and just don't waste your time for anything else. All right, so what is meant to be yours will be yours. If this person has to come your way, because I am seeing that we have Queen of Rods and King of Rods both in the same reading, so if this person is meant to be yours, he or she will come. You know, with the Judgment card, the day will come when, if they are meant. You know, sometimes you are apart from each other, you might be the twin flame of this person, you know, but the divine timing for you to meet them might not be this timing. You know, sometimes you might have to wait for years as well. But I'm not saying that you have to wait for years, but if you are meant to be together, because this is a very strong bond I'm seeing over here. Very nice reading, Aries. I'm seeing that you are working within yourself. There's a lot of work which you need to do, and you're doing that. All right, so that's all from my side, Aries. I hope you like the reading. If you really liked it, please give a thumbs up, and we'll meet you in the next reading. Till then, bye.